had to jump on today. Hi. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm doing this like it's a news broadcast or something like that. But it's not really a news broadcast. It is just something that any Jamaican in this world will have issues with. And wherever we are in this world, we love our homeland. We love Jamaica. Well, I'm speaking for myself. And I'm also speaking for many other Jamaicans as well all over the world. That when we see things which are happening that we're not happy with, we can do either different things. We can talk about it. We can look at it. We can try to create actions. Or we can just simply do nothing. Okay? And what I'm jumping on today with is the whole issue of the crime in Jamaica, the land of my birth, the land of our birth, the land that we love very much, and definitely, all right? Now, today I read in the papers, you know, as you know, I'm the director of Facilitators for Better Jamaica, the lobby group. I read in the papers about the killing of some young children. And also, even before Hurricane Matthew, there's been a spate of crime in areas like Montego Bay, and which they believe is linked a lot with the scamming issue and gunmen and all those different things. Even a video which showed altercation at a petrol station. I believe someone lost their lives right there. But the one which is actually very poignant, and the one which is really very... I'm just trying to find the article as we speak, just to sort of read it. The one which is very poignant and the one which is very gruesome is the killing of some children, and not just some children, the killing of people by the burning down of the house, okay? And I'm looking at an article here now. I'm looking at this article, and this article is by the Jamaica Gleaner. And it talks about the fairy screams of the children. Fairy screams of the children. And what is very disturbing is lots of children are being killed very regularly. Many years ago, growing up in Jamaica, those who are from Jamaica, know normally that you would not have gunmen killing children. You wouldn't have young men, gunmen killing parents, I mean, older people. Normally, they are normally killing other gunmen or other people. But what is very scary now is that there is no respect for any life at all. No lives matter. That is what it is. No lives matter. And in a country where all black lives should matter, no lives matter. Now, I'm completely scriptless at this point because, you know, I was thinking about trying to formulate some sort of ideas and some sort of thinking, but I just said, let me just jump on it, because sometimes when you actually just move in accordance to a passion or a particular issue, you tend to be a bit more effective, I believe, than trying to plan. Now, the fairy screams of the children. There, the fairy screams of the children. And this is kids tied up, shot. 14-year-old paralyzed. Right? And this is somber was the general mood yesterday at 7 March Pen Road in Spanish Town, St. Catherine, in the Africa settlement area, where 5 persons, including 3 children, were shot, killed, and their homes torched early last Sunday morning. It would have been 5 dead children instead of 3 if a 14-year-old girl was shot 10 times, had succumbed to injuries, and a 5-year-old girl, who some persons say was deliberately spared by the gangsters, had not been. The gunmen were reportedly wearing police vest, mask, and sporting high-powered rifles. 2 of the children killed, according to a family member who requested that his name not be used in the story, were murdered execution style. He told the gleaner that the 2 children aged, listen to this, 2 children aged 9 and 14 years were tied up by the hoodlums and then shot. I repeat, he told the gleaner that the 2 children aged 8, 9 and 14 years were tied up by the hoodlums and then shot. He said the little girl was spared from the attack, ran and hid until the smoke cleared. Everyone thought she was among the rebel dead, but she survived. The family member recounted the events he experienced leading up to the ordeal. He had a few meters away when it happened. Right. Very gruesome. Very, very gruesome. I just really want that to land really, you know, while I just let it saturate a bit more. You hear like them a lick off the gate. When them kick off the gate, you hear explosion, shots, firing non-stop, and the bare people are scream. So me come out to look if a police. When me come out and look, me see them in a police vest. Now, if you recall, recently, just after Hurricane Matthew bypassed Jamaica and went to Haiti, they found a massive cache of guns and ammunition in Haiti, which were destined for Jamaica. Now, the other issue is, where are all these guns coming from? Well, we know that Jamaica don't make guns. We know that Haiti don't make guns. So therefore, the guns are coming from somewhere. And when the guns actually come, there are other things to be looked at. Who sent the guns? Who is importing the guns? And the transshipment point, which is Haiti or so, who is handling the guns there? Who are the big men involved with the guns? Are there politicians involved with the guns? I think we've got to really do drastic things in order to address drastic atrocities. The killing, not just of young children, but the killings, period. You know? There's got to be this holy anger. I call it the holy anger. There's got to be an anger, something very repulsive about crime, period. Repulsive about crime, period, in Jamaica or anywhere else in the world. This is very serious. I go further. When we come out, then say, me, I fire shot, but escape about 15 to 20 of them. All in my mind, I try to come to the screaming, but I couldn't because it was a lot of them and them a fire shot. After the shot, listen, there were about 15 to 20 gunmen. After the shot, them start firing, come round, come see my family, then pan the ground, a burn up, and some of them a scream, same way. Guys, listen to this. This is heartbreaking. After the shot, them fire, and the place catch a fire, me come round, come, see my family, them pon the ground, a burn up, and some of them a scream, same way. Same way, sir. Katrina Hansen, mother of the 14-year-old girl who survived, told the gleaner that one side of her daughter's body is now paralyzed. Them no have no heart. that me know. When them kick off the door, me knows, them said the 2-year-old upon the bed, them couldn't save the two, they couldn't save the 2-year-old. Them gone already. Right? Now, you hear those gruesome things. And this is what we call it, maybe one episode of maybe many. One of the things that the police also said, that there are times some of these atrocities do not come to their knowledge. It is just by chance, what a police officer said, that they were driving through the particular area and buck up upon somebody, buck up on an atrocity there. It wasn't called in. So what we're hearing reported in the news are just those which have been reported and those which have been, we know about. So other atrocities are happening. They said, a curfew was ordered since Sunday was in full effect yesterday. Lawmen and soldiers were busy setting up and manning barricades at different spots through the community. The police were on a patrol, stopping and searching vehicles and civilians. The peace management initiative had a team in the area giving support to the family members of the victims. Meanwhile, the cabinet discussed the matter yesterday, and Prime Minister Andrew Holmes said he was deeply saddened by it. A gruesome murder was committed. The killings must end. The government is even more resolved to dismantle the gangs and bring peace. We have been hearing that from years ago. The government is now even more resolved and to dismantle the gangs. That has been something which has been said many times, many years. We all hear that. We know about that all the while. Every time. You know, when I was in Jamaica and I used to work in Kingston, I used to go down to T. Geddes Grand, face the commodity hunters on the downtown there. I used to pass through those areas, and I'm not going to call it ghetto areas, but the inner city areas. And you see all the zinc fences that borders the communities. And I keep always saying, why can't something be addressed about that? And this was all the way from 1990, 1991. I came to this country, the UK, 1992. Always bring that up. Always. Right? My crickets. Often these attacks are fueled by drug crazed individuals too. We shall overcome what we have to focus on the positive. Yes, I completely agree. Focus on the positive. But there's going to be some positive action which is maybe deemed as negative actions to really rid and deal with some of these terrible atrocities which are happening. Right? There's a lady named Maureen Morgan, who is a friend of Facilitators for Better Jamaica. She said, I may seem cold when I say that as horrified I am, I'm no longer shocked at the levels of violence. How low, how wicked a man can go. She said, for years I've been watching and speaking of the exponential rise in violence and the types of violence meted out and to whom. Maureen Morgan is part of the Griffin Trust. She's right there in the middle of things. Every time it rises, there's a public outcry. This is it. Every time it rises, there is a public outcry, a declaration of public disgust that the line has been crossed further. Yet again, a 9-day wonder that disappears with next atrocity. Guys, if we're serious about crime, we got to be serious about crime. If Jamaica is going to be serious about crime, Jamaica's got to be very serious about crime. It makes no sense to talking about it. The talking days are over. I don't know, it's the Renato Adams or whatever. I mean, one guy named Lester Gazimati, I'm going to get to what he said later with some action which he said, but what she's saying here, and I'll go back tomorrow. I've seen halfway tree filled with good citizens that protest the private lives of others while they remain silent on the daily abuse and murder of our children. Right? One of the reasons why maybe these things touch me is I'm a child care lawyer. My role working life as being protection of children, abuse and all these sort of things. That is my profession, mm-hmm. is always looking after children. She said, this thing, Jamaica, in my experience, everyone around them knows precisely who is responsible. Who is responsible? Right? And we'll all wash the blood out of their clothes for them, are shielding them and remain silent. People are shielding these gunmen. People are shielding these persons. People know them. They lay their heads somewhere. They sleep somewhere. We have got to, you see, when you say vote rap, you saw the word nation galvanize. Man, I want to say, damn, the nation galvanized. The nation pulled together. Everyone was out at halfway tree, hitting those pound yam and all those sort of things. People were saying, yes, me proud, me glad bus, me glad bad boss. We know the same. Such a massive emotional uproar of appreciation for Usain Bolt. So why can't we have a massive appreciation and outburst for life? A massive outburst and appreciation for life. One pastor said, a minister went down there, he said, churches should just stop having church in the church building and going to the communities and having church. Right? People should be going on the streets in Kingston or wherever it is, just like how when Usain Bolt win and when all those persons win, and to say no more. The time has got to come whereby persons, just like Lester said, start to snitch. But these are not snitch. This is national snitch. A national agenda of snitching. A national agenda of finding some numbers somewhere where we can report some of these. The red blood scar on the outfits, the gunshots and everything, somebody knows. Somebody knows. You know. Somebody out there will listen to my voice. You know. You know these gunmen. You know these persons who are creating these atrocities. You know the persons who are giving Jamaica a bad name. We've got to be serious. For drastic actions, you have to create something which has never been done before. We cannot allow for another 9-day wonder. This is what Morris said. Continue what Morris said. Mike, there is corruption. Everybody, listen, Jamaica is this place here whereby everybody keeps saying, me know that long time. There's always corruption in Jamaica. There's corruption there. There's corruption everywhere. Evidence, something turn up, somebody find out about something. We know that long time. I say go long time. That is what has been happening long time. People say that. Jamaicans say that all the while. That's what has been always happening. There is corruption. There must be corruption. Right? Because it just cannot keep happening like this where, listen, I'm not even going to juxtapose and talk about Jamaica crime rate is not as bad as some other countries or whatever like that, compared against Brazil, with compared against some other countries in South America, some other countries in Africa, whatever. I'm not into that. We're dealing directly now with Jamaica. We've got to really get a grip of this. This is what Mara said. Continue, Mara. It is not just the perpetrators of these crimes that sicken me. It is the mothers that also cover them. The women that lay down with them. The men that drink and socialize with them. That truly sickens me to my stomach, and they all know. God alone knows. Were it not for the children I'm committed to here. This is what she says. She's an Irish citizen in Jamaica. She said, if it wasn't for the children, I would have leave and gone, tired of the sick madness. Let us not kid ourselves. Let's not kid ourselves. Yes, Jamaica nice. Yes, everything. But listen, I know there are many positives. But in order to deal and to address this crime issue, we've got to pull together and we have to work together and we have to start saying enough is enough. Let the 9-day wonder be a lifetime wonder. Let it not slip and go under the 530 until another gruesome attack is. The blood of the children, the blood of those who are innocent, are crying out for justice. There must be justice. Alright? It goes further. And then a colleague, one of the members on facilitators for Better Jamaica, raised some points. He raised some very clear point about one of the ways forward. And this is it. This is what did Lester say. Let me see if I can find what Lester said here. But what
you guys think.
I mean, I don't want to just keep talking, but let me hear what your thoughts are on this issue. One person said, George Bunn said, Jamaicans for informants. Jamaicans for informants. Let's be proud informants. Let us be proud, but this is it now, and this is the catch-22 situation. Let's be proud informants. Jamaicans for informants. But there's always been cases whereby people say they're afraid to even tell the police because the police could be involved as well. My cricket, I agree for this to keep happening. I know they have turned this around in Colombia now and other South American because they work with the police force in these countries and they did confront their, let me see what this is saying. They did confront their corruption to using the ways, right? Now, that is a solution Mike Ricketts is talking about, right? And we've got to look at different things. Some of the comments here, tragic, sad, barbaric, heartless and wicked. Wickedness increased, gruesome, heartless. One person said, I'm sorry, but prison is too good for these heartless criminals. They need to be put in a place with some big snakes, so wicked. Right? One person said, this person here saying, as some of the solutions, because we're looking for solutions as well. What is needed is for these communities all across Jamaica to really feel the iron fist. To really feel the iron fist. From your call at dawn, the army should go for you and no one sees you again. Ladies and gentlemen, for those coming on, I'm talking about the recent gruesome killing of some children in Jamaica where they were burned to death and fiery screams and gunmen there killing them. Don't know what the nature of it is. Could be gangland or whatever, but the children caught right in the middle of it. This is it. All your assets to be seized and placed in an account to disperse the families of those killed by you or any other. Not a solution. Shut down these communities, let the army free reign to work like in 2010 after the Tivoli incident. That's a controversial one, but anyhow, that's the first one to say. Do serious cavity search of every house. Cavity search of every house, every square meter of these communities. If guns are found on these premises without the person volunteering to tell the police during this operation, they go to upper camp. Any illegal contraband, including scamming data sheets, drug weapons, anything illegal found on that property, to be seized. Any adult male found, any underage female, any underage female found pregnant and or with a child will be arrested, the father arrested, the parents of the men arrested also. I mean, some of these sound a bit OTT, but for gruesome atrocities, for dangerous atrocities, for uncharted territories of atrocities, gonna require uncharted actions, drastic measures, because we have to find the solution. And hear this one. Driving violators will be given 1 month to pay all fines if not we hunt you down. This is looking at a whole scale thing of law and order. Any politician, businesswoman, religious leaders, judge, police, etc., that is known to link with criminals and dons, you will be arrested, assets seized, and we will not see you again. We'll not see you again. Don't know what that means, but what it's saying, look, you know, put them in prison and throw away the key. Scooch. Anyhow, I think what is happening now, there is a lot of people talking, you know, but I think that one of the way forward is for a common ground, a common unity with Jamaicans, right? Common unity whereby people have a level of pride, have a level of fearlessness in order to actually unite and make a decision to have a better Jamaica. Compared to many countries, we're not that bad. But why not have the best? Why not be excellent? We have greatness, great people, but we have a small element of our people which are causing this problem. So therefore, as the Governor General said, what is wrong with Jamaica can be made right with what is right for Jamaica. Right? Now, I don't know if I got that right properly, but what he's saying is, what is wrong with Jamaica can be made right with what is right for Jamaica. What is wrong with Jamaica can be fixed with what is right for Jamaica. So what is wrong with Jamaica right now, in one aspect, is law and order in the area of bad boys, gunmen, and all those sort of things which are creating a problem, right? Influences. We've got to deal with this scourge of crime. Every single person must be held accountable and responsible to see. Listen, I'm doing the bit that I can do here now, trying to light some fire from London, from the UK, from England. I'm not there. I created this organization which is called Facilitators for Better Jamaica, that people can talk. We can try to find some solutions. I know people read it. Many groups around. Got to take it from the group into some action. No time for play business anymore. Need some hardcore action. I hear what somebody said here. Another person said here, Evadne Cabbage, he said, this is not only sad, Silver. This is barbaric. And anyone harboring this criminal should face the same penalty. I know many people are scared for their own lives, so they can't do any better. But the entire community has to come together and let these people know they have no place to hide. It grieves your heart to read some of the stories. A beautiful island like Jamaica being destroyed by violence. Idle hand. As I keep saying, Jamaica's a beautiful country, lovely, wood of water, But you've got to look at it to the point to say that it is being destroyed at presently with unlawfulness, criminal activities, murder, rape, police, thief. As we say in school, health, rape, murder, police, thief. If that went on, they all need to be hunted down like dogs. I've never been one for capital punishment, is what she's saying. But more and more, when I read of some of these heinous crimes being committed in Jamaica, particularly against children, it makes you wonder if these people should be allowed to live. It really makes me so angry. And that's it. We have got to get angry. We have got to get angry about crime. We have got to develop a holy anger against crime. We must say that there's a declaration that there will no more be any killing of children in Jamaica. We've got to stand our ground. We've got to say it. And when we say it and when we mean it, we don't get complacent and we do not feel that this is the norm. And that's what is happening. I speak to some people from here, sometime in Jamaica. Have you heard about this? Boy, I say go on, can it now get better? I say still from long time. Just say there's nothing now change. Me just go about my business and just get scared and go my yard and stuff like that. So what happened now? When good men don't do anything, evil prevails. But when it comes close to a person, when it comes close to your home, when it comes close to you as an individual, then it's become relevant. So yes, I'll clean up the community and create an environment which will restore pride. You know, Mike, you know, I agree with that. And that's one of the things which I spoke about regarding the zinc fences and all those sort of things. You know, pride, I believe, is external and internal. Change of the... I know there's a poverty issue there as well, but there are many people who grew up in poverty and excel. Many people are poor, but they excel at the same time, you know, based on something which is built inside of them. We must, listen, you know, I wouldn't ask for this guy, the Philippine president who was just declared war against all joggers and all those sort of things, killing them off, give free rein, locking them up left, right and center, because that was a mandate which he got into office for. And he's doing that, you know. I don't know. I said, thou shalt not kill. I don't know, you know. But there's time for drastic actions, you know. I just really wanted to jump on here, just to share my heart on this particular issue regarding this crime, because it's terrible. And then, you know, you got dogs killing, biting of children and stuff like that. Got to do something with these bulldogs and everything like that. It's heartbreaking, man. Especially with the children. It's tough, you know. So all I've got to say is, guys, develop a holy anger and don't be complacent when it comes to crime. Don't shut oneself off because it is not affecting you directly. But just like with Usain Bolt, when everyone gathers at halfway tree and everyone blowing their horn and making that noise and everybody banging on their pots and their yam and their banana and all those sort of things and coming together and saying, we're proud, we're glad about boss. Just like how everybody galvanized and pulled together when Hurricane Matthew was coming and people prayed and everything. I tell you this, prayer do work. I know many people sometimes don't like when people say, well, prayers, or even with the whole issue with Matthew when they say, we prayed and God spared us and stuff like that. Listen, at the end of the day, our life is in the hands of God. Right? And God plays a part. Now, we don't know, and I don't know, about God's plan. God's plan for Haiti, God's plan for Jamaica. But we are a blessed country as well. We're a blessed country. But at the same time, we've got to be very careful, man. Barry Taylor, I'm so fed up with crime and violence in Jamaica. I was there, and the process of opening up business there, and I'm really pondering fresh. Too much talk there, no action. right? So people in the diaspora as well want to go home as well, and they are pondering. So therefore, it will affect the state of the economy, without a doubt. It will. There is a direct and an indirect effect, direct effect. And as I said, and I keep saying it again, it is not saying Jamaica is bad, bad, bad in comparison, but I keep saying, let's not juxtapose, yeah? But let us simply, let us simply address the fact that crime is there. Accept it in the sense of not accepting the crime, but acknowledge that it is a reality. Only when you acknowledge that there's a problem, then it can be fixed. And it's got to be a national incentive. Initiative. It must be a national initiative. Must be a national initiative. You know? I want to bless the Prime Minister and the government for what they are doing. I'm not going to be one that criticizes. I want to bless the police and the work that they are doing. I'm not going to be one that criticizes. I want to bless all the crime fighters, the policies that is working towards crime. I'm not one to be criticized. All I can say is step up the plate. Step it up one next match. Step it up to the next level. And let us fight crime. Let us fight for Jamaica. Let us have Jamaica to be a better Jamaica. Fight for it. Fight for the land that we love, my people. Fight. Because we deserve it. We are blessed. We're highly favored. We are Jamaica. And I will keep bringing this up as time goes by. I'll talk about it and I'll keep pushing it. And I'll keep harping on the whole issue of crime. We've got to address crime. We've got to deal with it. We can't afford to have our children. You know, I was listening to some music today. It reminded me of growing up in Ocho Rios. It reminded me of when we could go up and down late at night, playing outside, you know. They say there are some clowns going around the place and stuff like that. I remember when Current gone, JPS, Current gone, and when Current gone, what we'll do still, we'll still play outside with moonshine and sing moonshine tonight, come on, let us sing moonshine tonight. Come on, let us sing. And we'll play. And we'll run joke. We'll run duppy stories. And we'll say the duppy manna come. Rolling calf manna come. We could play like that outside. But I don't know if people can do that now. Can they? We would sit on the veranda and play. My sisters, my brothers. Happy birthday, my sister Claudia in Jamaica. The happy birthday to her. We could do that. But people are scared. People won't do those things anymore. But it locked off. You're driving into your home. You're actually looking behind you. Careful. Serious things, man. I've always been bringing this up. And I'm challenging every single Jamaican in Jamaica to fight the scourge of crime somehow, somewhere, and there. Challenge the government as well to do the bit and the best that they can do for Jamaica. Those who are corrupted, I pray that God have mercy upon you at the same time. The gunmen, the police who are linked with crime and corruption, may God have mercy upon you and touch your heart. The politician who is involved with crime, may God have mercy upon you, repent. And make some change. The mothers, the sisters, the girlfriends who are harboring gunmen, may God have mercy upon you. The blood of children and the blood of people are on your hands. Gosh, it's heartbreaking. You know? And I pray that none of these atrocities will ever come to anyone. We can make a better Jamaica. And I will see a better Jamaica. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to say good night. I want to bless you and keep you. May the Lord blessings shine upon you. And may his peace be upon you in Jamaica, land we love. I'm SYLBOURNE SHOW, and I'm out. Bye-bye.